we want to use the provided fraction wall to identify equivalent fractions for each given fraction. Equivalent fractions are different fractions that are equal to the same value or same number. To use the fraction wall, we first define the long blue rod as one whole. So if we cut or denominate this into two equal partitions or two equal pieces, as we see above, each of these rods are equal to 1/2. If we cut or denominate one whole into three equal partitions or three equal pieces, as you see in this row, each of these rods are equal to 1/3. If we cut or denominate one whole into four equal partitions or four equal pieces, as we see here, each of these rods are equal to 1/4. Similarly, each of these rods are equal to 1/6, and then we have a 1/8 rod, a 1/12 rod, and a 1/24 rod. To find the equivalent fractions shown in the fraction wall for 1/4, we begin by identifying the 1/4 rod, which would be this rod here. And now from here, any train of rods or sequence of rods that have the same length as the 1/4 rod would give us an equivalent fraction. So any train of rods that have this length would give us an equivalent fraction. So looking at our fraction wall, this indicates we can determine an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 8, with a denominator of 12, and with a denominator of 24. Let's begin by looking at the 1/8 rods. Notice if we count or enumerate the number of 1/8 rods that would give us the same length as a 1/4 rod, it takes 1, 2 rods of length 1/8 to have the same length as a 1/4 rod, which indicates that 2/8 is equivalent to 1/4. Now let's take a look at the 1/12 rods. Again, if we count or enumerate the number of 1/12 rods that would be equal to 1/4, it takes 1, 2, 3 rods of length 1/12 to equal 1/4, which means 3/12 is equivalent to 1/4. And now looking at the 1/24 rods, it takes 2, 4, 6 of those rods to have the same length as a 1/4 rod, which indicates that 6/24 is equivalent to 1/4. So all these fractions are different but equal, which means they're equivalent fractions. Of course, there are many other equivalent fractions to 1/4, but these are the only ones shown on our fraction wall. Let's take a look at our second example. We have 2/3. To model 2/3 using our rods, we'll have to use two rods of length 1/3. So 2/3 again would be two rods of length 1/3 here. So all the equivalent fractions would be trains of different rods that have the same length, meaning they'd have to have this length here. So looking at our rods, notice how we can determine equivalent fractions with a denominator of 6, with a denominator of 12, and with a denominator of 24. Let's first find the equivalent fraction with a denominator of 6. To find the numerator, we would count or enumerate the number of 1/6 rods that would be equal to 2/3. So notice how it takes 1, 2, 3, 4 rods of length 1/6 to equal 2/3, which means 4/6 is equivalent to 2/3. Now looking at the 1/12 rods, let's count or enumerate them. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rods of length 1/12 that would equal 2/3, so 8/12 is equivalent to 2/3. And then finally, we'll count or enumerate the 1/24 rods that would give us a length of 2/3. We'd have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 rods of length 1/24 to equal 2/3, which means 16/24 is equivalent to 2/3. Next, we have 5/12. To model 5/12, we'd have to use 5 rods of length 1/12, which would look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1/12 rods. Again, any train of rods with this length would give us an equivalent fraction. And notice the only rods we can use this time would be the 1/24 rods. So we'll counter enumerate the number of 1/24 rods. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 1/24 rods is equal to 5/12. So 10/24 is equivalent to 5/12. And for the last example, we have 7/8. To model 7/8, we'd have to use 7 1/8 rods. So here are the 1/8 rods. We want 7 of them. So we have 7/8. And now to find the equivalent fractions, we're looking for the train of rods that would have the same length, or this length here. And notice how using this wall, the only train we can build would be using the 1/24th rods. So let's go ahead and count or enumerate the number of 1/24th rods that would be equal to 7/8. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 21. Since it takes 21 1/24th rods to equal 7/8 or 7 1/8 rods, 21 1/24 is equivalent to 7/8. So using a fraction wall is a nice way to visualize equivalent fractions. I hope you found this helpful.